So our next question is HIFU a good treatment for whole gland ablation?
It's a potential treatment. I haven't gotten super excited about HIFU because of trying to find doctors that are really good at doing it. But it is an alternative. I'm not using it very much because I think the doctors that are giving radiation treatments for whole gland treatment have more experience, and in general will probably get better outcomes.
So how often, you know, we talk about brachytherapy a lot on our channel, and obviously that's putting radiation seeds in the prostate. The question that we have from this person is, do those seeds ever migrate? And if so, what type of issues would the patient have if they did?
So rarely they migrate. It has a lot to do with the skill of the doctor putting the seeds in. If they're put in the wrong place, they're more likely to migrate. What will happen is they get into the bloodstream and they'll wash down and get caught in the lung, which sounds kind of dreadful, but it turns out doesn't really have much of any consequences. So the skill of the doctor putting the seeds in is incredibly important. But I don't see that as a negative reason to forego doing seed implants. It's not a dangerous proposition, even if they do migrate.
And when you say rarely, like what percentage have you seen with patients?
Less than 1%.
Okay. So it's very rare. Mm-hmm. Okay. And if it does, I mean, I guess that's dependent on the seed, but if the seed does get lodged in the lungs and it shows up on a scan, is that a permanent situation or a temporary situation, depending on the seed type?
Yeah, I mean, when you scan people's lungs, you'll not only, if you found a seed, I mean, it would be amongst other calcium deposits and bumps and lumps that people collect in their lungs through their lifetime. It's never been shown to have any negative. It doesn't cause lung malfunction or anything of that nature.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five. Can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.